Hello there, Lindsay here, the Frugal Crafter. Today we're going to do a little acrylic painting. I'm going to start with a little bit of opaque blue, which is about, I would say, very, very similar to ultramarine. So go ahead and use ultramarine. I grabbed this blue because it was actually clearance 10 AC more, and it was a nice, like, kind of primary blue, and I needed some for a class I was teaching. So what I'm doing is just adding this blue here up at the top and just kind of dragging it down with some choppy strokes. Add a little bit more. The canvas is a little dry. And this is the economy canvas from AC Moore, which I think is fine for doing some sketches. Now I'm going to pick up white. As you can see, I've got a very fancy palette here. It's my packaging for my markers I bought the other day. So see, I do use my stuff quite frequently, quite often too. I'm thinking I might want this actually textured background, so I'm going to try not to blend it too much. Now, this is a stretch canvas, so and it's wrapped around so the edges will be neat, and you can actually just put a wire across to hang it if you want to. You don't need to frame it, and it will still look pretty good, so I want to make sure I'm getting around the edges and painting them too. And on the edges, I might even add just a touch of water to stretch the paint a little bit. Because, you know, I just want to get something there. And I am painting quicker than you probably want to paint at home. I'm just trying to get a little bit of estimation about how long this particular piece will take me. Because if it takes me 20 minutes, it'll take a class probably an hour and a half. So that's kind of my rule of thumb when teaching. A lot of times, like the watercolor cards I do, I'll do those in classes, and it will take a full hour and a half for my students to get them done. And of course, that's with drying time and, you know, chit-chatting time and all that stuff. But you don't want it to be, at least I don't want my classes to feel like a race. I know my videos probably do. They probably feel like a race, but I don't, you know, you can always pause it if you need to. Sometimes I'm, you know, stuck by constraints of actual time and reality of when I need to get things done and how quickly I have to do them. So I'm keeping the sky choppy and rough. You can smooth it out if you prefer, completely up to you. One trick you can do for smoothing it is actually going in with a larger brush and just kind of working back and forth. Oh, I do kind of like that too. Maybe I will smooth the sky. Just go back and forth. And I like to work at the start from the top and work my way down so I get a gentle fade. Now the reason I'm using blue is because it's going to make the yellow orange of the tulips really stand out. I'm coming 2/3 of the way down my paper with the sky. Rule of thirds, you know, it's good to break up your piece in thirds. And no, I'm not worried about the paint on my table. I know some of you guys are probably like, Lindsay, you're getting your cutting mat all painted. Have you seen the cutting mat? It's nothing that pristine. Just touching up the edges, because that is what a Linny do. Oh, by the way, some people call me Linny. That's my nickname, I guess. My dad always called me that. My husband called, actually, it's probably just my sister and my husband called me that now, my dad. Or Linny Lubird. A little glimpse into my life. There we go, we're in frame. I'm cooking with fire. All right, now acrylic paint. Don't let it dry on your brushes, so plop it right in your water if you're gonna not be using it for a while. Now I wanna get some green in the action. I've got a little sap green here. I'm picking it up right with my dirty brush. Adding that here on the bottom. These strokes, when I go like that, those are called scumbling strokes. Kind of cross-hatching. I can even get into a little bit of yellow there if I want to. And I like to do that because I like to keep reusing the colors on my palette. So this would be like a cadmium yellow. It's actually, I think it's called opaque yellow in the ceram coat line. But it's pretty much a cadmium yellow. Or maybe even a cad yellow light. Or cad, I'd say cad yellow medium because it's not a cool yellow. So I'm just using a little bit of that because I want this kind of out of focus background. Look, I'm even bringing it up into the sky a little bit so I have a really soft focus. I do want to make sure that I am covering the canvas. I don't want white peeking out of the canvas. And people, like, it was funny, I was in the store yesterday. I was at AC Moore. I was doing a little, I showed you my haul. Of course, I don't know if this is gonna be posted the day after my haul. I'm not sure. I never know. Sometimes I upload stuff and it just stays there in my YouTube holding pen for a while before I actually post it. But a lady came up to me and asked me if ask me about different acrylic paints and they're, because they have so many different lines, there's so many different grades, so many different prices. I have to say, sometimes you don't get very much paint in a bottle if you're getting one of the like cheaper student grades, like Reeves or Marie's, and you can go through that really quick. So I think you'd probably be better off, rather than getting those, you probably would be better off getting like the 2 ounce bottles of Ceram Coat or Folk Art or Americana. Those are all like really consistent and reputable brands of craft acrylic paint. I've noticed like the Apple Barrel and like the, a lot of times the store brands aren't that great. And you know, every, it's almost like every paint company too will make like a better brand and kind of like a cheaper brand. And some companies make, like I think Plaid, for instance, makes several lines of craft acrylic paint. So, you know, Ceram Coat, Folk Art, Americana, those are all pretty comparable. They're fairly opaque. They're they're soft bodied, so they're not going to hold your like thick strokes. You'd have to add a medium to that for that. But you know, just so you know. Okay, I'm just taking a look at this now. Oh, the interesting thing, if you're primarily a watercolorist and you're getting used to acrylics, acrylics shift darker. Okay, so keep that in mind. So, you know, in watercolors, you always go a little bit darker because you know it's going to go lighter. Acrylics go darker, so I'm actually adding a little bit of white here and yellow into my, the kind of the ground area, because I know it's going to shift a little light on me and I really don't want that. I don't want it to be any darker. It's going to shift darker, yeah, so I want it nice and bright. I like to see the brush strokes. If you don't like that, you can blend them out. It's completely up to you. Okay? You don't have to do something a certain way just because I'm doing it that way. And I am going around getting my edges while I'm at it. Alright, so I'm going to stick that brush right in my water bucket because I don't have a chance to wash it right now. But when I shut the camera off, I'll go upstairs and wash it. Just want to let you know that. Alright, so now I'm going to switch to a softer brush, a synthetic brush. I'm sorry if I'm over-explaining. Some of you guys are probably going to be like, Lindsay, I know how to paint with acrylics. But some of you guys don't, and if you're, I don't paint with acrylics very often, so I just want to make sure that you guys have the information. If it's too, if I'm going too slow, go ahead and put it on double speed or whatever. I just want to make sure nobody's kind of left out. Now I'm going to use white to paint the flowers. This is Blockout White by Chromacryl. I really like this paint. I took a chance. I'd never used it before, but I needed some for a class and I ordered it from Blick, and I think it turned out to be like $8 for this 16 ounce bottle, and it doesn't take it, a little goes a long way, and it's super opaque. So, but that's the Blockout White. I was trying to decide between the Blockout and the regular titanium white, and I'm really happy with that. Of course, it's not great for glazing because it is so opaque, but I just wanted to offer that recommendation if you're looking for a good, bright, reliable studio container of white paint to have, especially if you are a teacher. And I am going to be doing that video on how to set up like a sip and paint kind of class. Those of you that are looking to earn a little bit of money from your art, and those of you that, you know, would be interested in teaching, hopefully you'll find that video useful. And I am kind of collecting questions for that, so if you do have questions about teaching and you're thinking that you might like to do that on the side or maybe as a career, just leave them in the video description or email them to me or whatever. I'm just jotting them down as people send them in. Some people have sent in the same question, so I'm just gonna cover all that stuff in one video coming up in a day or two probably. And hopefully that helps you guys out, because I think teaching is an extremely rewarding profession, even if you just moonlight, even if you just do it once in a while. I think it's extremely, extremely fun. It's not for everybody, that's for sure. Some people don't care for it. I like it. But I have to say though, the more I've been doing YouTube versus teaching in real life, I have to say I really enjoy the YouTube. It's fun. But it's nice to have the mix of both. I enjoy teaching in person as well. All right, so I've got three big tulip heads there. And see, I'm sketching with a paint, just like if it was a brush. So I'm trying to decide whether I want some others. I think I might put two more in there. The photo I'm going from is by Kathy Paulus, and I'll put a link below. It's from Paint My Photo. And I will, you know, throw that in there. You'll see that I did change things up quite a bit, but it's a great reference photo. And they actually, there's so many great reference photos. And I don't know if I mentioned it at the beginning of the video, because I've been feeling very scattered today. Somebody emailed me a gorgeous picture of tulips against a blue sky, and I went and looked and couldn't find it. I thought it was in my Facebook messages, and I just couldn't find it. Maybe it was emailed to me. I couldn't find it, so I apologize, but I think this is going to be pretty close to the other photo that was sent to me by another viewer. I didn't even look through my request page. I thought, well, probably maybe it was in there. I couldn't find the darn thing, so I apologize. Now, these ones that aren't my three first ones, the focal ones, I'm actually going to dip right into my yellow, and I am going to, I'm going to add some color to them, because these are going to kind of be background blurry ones. I think I need to clean my brush, though, because I got a little too much green in there. And so, you know, we're getting more detailed as we go, just like we do with watercolors, or just like I do with watercolors anyway. Starting off really vague and get more detailed as we go. And we'll do this one over here. I know, they just look like blobs now. Bear with me. My dog is hearing the... So it snowed again today. Hello, Maine. Welcome to my world. Snowed again today, so the dog is all freaked out, you know, because he can hear the snow come off the roof, because we have a metal roof, and it just kind of slips and slides, and she tip-taps all over the house and drives me bonkers a little bit. Oh, I'll be ready for spring. I think she will be too. All right, I'm going to grab a little bit of red, just a little bit on my brush. Should slide my palette over here so you can see my fancy palette. I'm going to get a palette sponsorship. So I was going to, like, oh my gosh, Lindsay, use our palettes. We're sick of looking at your plastic packaging. And I'm just going to add a little bit of red into the bottom of that one. And it's very transparent. Red is very transparent. It's showing the background through quite a bit. But once it dries, I can go over that. I just wanted to get a little bit in there right off the bat. All right, I'm going to go add some stems to these because there's not much I can do to the flowers now while they're still wet. I'm going to go right in with sap green. When I load up my brush, if I want a nice fine point, because somebody did ask me that, I'm just going to get my brush in there, then I'm going to twirl it, and that's going to kind of point the paint. And notice how I don't have the paint all the way up the bristles. It's only about halfway up because I do not want paint to touch the metal part. When paint touches the metal part, paint gets up under the bristles into the metal part, and then it is really bad news for your brush. If you can just avoid the paint getting up that far to begin with, your brushes are going to be so much easier to clean, and they're going to last you a lot longer. So take care of those brushes. They're an investment. And if you play cards right, they are going to last you a very long time, regardless of what brand you choose to use. There's a lot of good ones out there. Putting in my stems. I don't know if I'll do this one as a speed paint as well as a regular tutorial. I'm not sure. Probably depends on how long it is. If it's under 20, I might just leave it as regular. If it's over 20, I might do both. I haven't really looked back at my statistics to see how the speed paint version did compared to the long one. I had an overwhelming support for the long one from, you know, people, I think from people who actually want to learn how to paint. But I have to say, a lot of people that didn't paint just really enjoyed the entertainment of watching it come together. So you know, it's all good. I always wonder that. I'm like, is it better to put both versions up, or does it make it look like my videos aren't getting watched as much because you don't have as many views on a video? I don't know. I don't want it to dilute my viewership, but it's really not that hard to add as an option, I have to say. Okay, I think I'm going to have to let this dry for a few minutes, and we'll be back and we'll add some more layers. I've just dried this, and I think I want to add one more layer of white onto those tulips, because I want to make sure I'm going to have some nice opaque area to paint on with my yellow. So I'm adding some white, and pay no attention to the loud noise in the background. Not only do you have to deal with my space heater, but now the actual furnace is on. April in Maine. Gotta love springtime. The only place you can go skiing in the spring. I'm not kidding, too. The ski places are still open. Oh, I wish I liked skiing. I haven't tried it, so I might like it. I don't know. I don't like cross-country skiing that much, I'll tell you that. I don't like being cold is my thing. All right, I'm gonna heat this again, dry it. Hopefully by the time I'm done with that, the furnace will be off and we can mosey on forward with this painting. Okay, now that these have a white underpainting to them and these have a yellow, these are going to be much brighter and really come forward more. So that's the reason I wanted to have that distinction. Okay, so I'm going to pick up some of this yellow paint. I think I'll start with, I'm gonna start this flower way up here in the corner. And I am going to paint on the flower petals. I'm kind of just filling in. Now it doesn't have to just stay within the shape. It's okay, because where the flowers overlap, they tend to look more opaque, but then when you have ones that are kind of just going over the background, it'll look a little more transparent, like there's, like how it does in real life, how you can kind of see the translucence through the petals. So that's going to be fine. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about anything. You're painting. It's going to be fun. Now, if you're an oil painter and you're trying out acrylics for the first time, you may be frustrated with how quickly they dry. There are mediums you can add to that, to your paint. I'm picking up a little bit of red to make it dry a little bit slower. So, you know, keep that in mind if you're finding a lot of frustration with that. I know a lot of people switch over to acrylics because of allergies, or they just don't want to have the solvents in their house, or maybe they've had children recently and they just don't want to expose them to the solvents. There are mediums to make your acrylic paints behave, and yes, I will be doing a tutorial on mediums. It's just I need like a full day to prepare that and film it, and a lot of my pretty much all my videos I've been doing lately have been done, I've been working around other deadlines and things, and they've just been done in little, you know, half hour blocks that I have here and there. So it's not that I don't want to do it or that I'm ignoring anybody or anything like that. It's just finding the time. So again, please bear with me. I will have that video up hopefully sooner rather than later. So I'm just kind of divided between some of the petals there. I'm going to mix in some yellow so I can blend it a little bit. Make them look a little more natural. This isn't our focal one, so it's good to start on one that you're not like really counting on being the stunning one. I'm gonna wipe off my brush. I don't really want to introduce more water if I don't have to. And I'm picking up some white, and I'm gonna kind of streak that up into the highlight areas, right into the wet paint. And I'm just suggesting the edges of these petals, okay? So much of painting is just kind of theater, you know, you're just suggesting. All right, now where the flower touches the stem, we're gonna have some green. I'm again wiping my brush. I'm gonna pick up some of that sap green. And I am just going to pull it up. You might want to switch to a round brush for here. I'm using the chisel edge and kind of turning my brush as I go. But if you're more comfortable doing this with a round brush, by all means, switch to a round brush. There. So that's our furthest away tulip. Let me bring it up a little bit for you. Okay. And now we'll do this one here in the middle. Plus that way I won't put my hand in some wet paint if I work my way across. I think this is going to be a longer video because I can see we're already at 18 minutes. So for this one, I'm going to again paint it all yellow. And you'll notice that acrylic brushes and oil brushes tend to have longer handles, and the reason for that is generally when you're painting with an acrylic, when you're painting acrylics or oils, you'd be at a easel. So that's why. So you can step back a bit and have a little distance between you and the work. Now here, how I'm filming, I have the canvas on my table, so I'm looking down at it. So I sometimes when you're painting like that, your vision will be skewed a little bit. So if you don't have an easel or you prefer to sit when you work, I recommend that you put a couple books. You can put newspaper over it. Put a couple books so you can tip your painting towards you, so you kind of eliminate that skew, that distortion there. It'll make it easier when you're painting. All right, so we've based that in with the yellow. And we're again gonna grab some red Not a lot, just a little bit on the tip. Okay, just get a little bit on the tip of the brush. And I'm just gonna, this one doesn't have as much red on it, so I'm just gonna kind of just tap and touch along the edges of my, I'm just kind of gently dragging it through the paint there, just so I get a little bit on the tip, because red is very strong, and if you get too much, it can be hard to get rid of. And this one here. And then you get kind of that look, how the petals get kind of that fringing on the edge. I'm gonna do over here. It's funny how the same type of flower can look so different. So you're kind of doing a little bit of an outline here. And again, we're going to grab a little more yellow on this brush with a little red, and that's going to give us kind of like a warm orangey color. We've only used, look what we've used. We've used like an ultramarine blue, we've used white, sap green, cadmium yellow, and cadmium red. That's it. That's all we've used. Okay, because acrylics mix very easily. So that's another nice thing, is that you don't have to go out and buy a zillion colors of paint. You know, not that you don't really have to with any medium, really. Sometimes it's fun, but it's not necessary, and you'll become a better painter if you learn how to control what you have. Now on this side there should be a little bit of a shadow, so what I'm going to do is actually pick up a little bit of that blue. Okay, I'm just, I mean just a tiny smidgen, and I'm mixing it to what I have, that orangey kind of that I have on my brush. I'm making myself a gray. A little bit more red and yellow in there because it's a little too dark. And I'm going to add that into the shadow area here, because it's tilting away from the sun and it's darker down there. And then if I need to add, I'm going to add a little bit of water to that because it feels dry. Probably because I have a space heater going and the furnace is going and the air is dry. This is going to dry a little bit lighter in this case because I have water in it that's kind of making it look a little bit wetter and glossier at the moment. And just get a little bit of shadow in there as well. Now I'm going to clean and wipe my brush off and blend those edges, because the edges are a little too harsh. Gosh, if I knew this furnace was going to be on this long, I would have just paused the video. Somebody said it wasn't that loud, but I think they're just being nice. I feel like Ed Wood. That's a wrap. No retakes. Goodness gracious, I've been so busy lately. I love having the daily posts, and I'm going to do it as long as I can, but I've got to tell you, it's been a struggle some days to get a new video out for you. Okay, now I want to add some highlights. Actually, I think I want to soften the edge a little bit more. I think the white really adds so much. And it's almost like a treat to use white, because I do watercolors mostly, and I don't use white. I'm using the paper, so it is kind of like, it's a little bit of a treat. I don't know, I feel a little naughty using white, I guess. Okay, let's do a little bit of white towards the tips here. Bring out the highlights. We might need to add a little yellow to it. It feels like it's blending in pretty well, but if not, we'll add a little yellow. Not the end of the world, don't freak if your paint is drying on you. I know it's a whole different ball game than watercolor or oils. Actually, I have to say, painting in acrylics is not my, like, if I'm going to choose something to paint for enjoyment, I would not choose acrylics. It just doesn't fit my personality that well, but teaching people that have never painted before how to paint something, I find acrylics almost the easiest one. It's like a great entry-level drug. I don't know what to call it. It's like entry-level. It's a great entry-level medium, because there's so many possibilities. They're easy to obtain. They're not as expensive as other mediums. I mean, some are, obviously, some of the artist quality acrylics are, like the Goldens and the Liquitex, but you can get in at a much lower price point, and I like that. All right, and I'm going to do a little bit of green down at the bottom like I did on the other one. This time I think I'll use the round brush. Do a little bit of that green right down here. Not a lot though, this one doesn't have so much in it. There we go. And we're gonna move on to this one. Okay, I have 2 hours to teach my class tonight, so hopefully it'll time out just about right. Alright, again, we're going to base coat with a yellow. I'm also getting a good idea of how much paint I'm going to need to squeeze out for my students, because this is new for me, and I'm running short on the yellow, so I'll know exactly how much I need. And also, I hadn't used this paint before, so I wanted to make sure that it was going to cover and be good before I did the gloss. These canvases are decent, actually. They're quite a bargain. At $20 for 10, regular price, and then you can use a coupon on it at AC Moore, so you can't worry about messing them up when you pay that much for it, you know, when you're not paying an arm and a leg. I like that. My girls love to paint on canvas. They get a kick out of it, I think, because it feels like a real, you know, art supply, and it feels fancy. I want to kind of redraw the edge there. I felt like I lost an edge. Okay. This dimension is an 8x10 canvas. Oh, thank goodness the furnace went off. Alright, now I'm going to again load my brush up, and I'll show you again in case you didn't catch it. Just a little bit of red. Obviously, I put too much red out. You don't need much red. Just loading up the tip. And yes, my paint is kind of traveling up, but it's because my brush has been rinsed off and reloaded with paint. If the brush is wet, the paint does want to travel, so I'll just be real careful to wash that well. And I'm just going to tap and draw on this petal. They have a pretty, like, red outline on them. It's pretty. Yes, the pretty red outline is, in fact, pretty. I'm redundant. It's hard to paint and talk. People don't realize. They don't realize. That's why so many people voice over the painting videos. It's hard. Why is life so hard? Got it rough. I'm painting. No, I don't have it rough. Alright, let's get this guy drawn in here. Get that little petal. Get another one in there. My paint is drying though, I will tell you that. I'm gonna get a little bit of water on my brush just to moisten it. There we go. So I hope my class goes well tonight. I'm full of beginners. Should be fun. It's at a place I haven't been at, the Co Space in Bangor. It's kind of a neat concept. Like, you can rent out, just like a public space you can rent out, but it's a for-profit business, but it's kind of like a community center, but it's just neat. Seems neat. I've never been there before. I'm looking forward to it. I don't think it's very big. All right, I'm going to add a little yellow. I feel like I've gotten a little too red on that one, but that's a great thing about acrylics. You can keep painting over and going in and adding more. Yeah, that's another reason I really like acrylics for beginners. Because not everybody has the attitude for watercolor. Watercolor, I think, demands kind of like a devil-may-care type of attitude. And if you get really bogged down in the details, if you're easily flustered, watercolor might be a frustrating experience. You know, for the longest time, I thought the word was flustrated and not frustrated or flustered. Until I was in college, I thought that it was flustrated was the real word, and people saying frustrated were wrong. Do you ever have words like that? Another fun fact, I couldn't swallow an aspirin until I was like 25 years old. I had to crush up all of my pills or aspirin or Tylenol or anything like that. Like, take chewable vitamins. Yes, I'll take a Flintstones with my morning cup of coffee. Very sad. I was so worried I was going to choke. I bet that's a real fear. I got over it, though, luckily. Oh, we talk about some strange things when we've been painting, don't we? It's like we're in the sharing mode. We just all want to share. I do anyway. Yeah, like I gotta tip this towards me so I can see what the heck I'm painting. Hey, that's not too bad. All right, I'm gonna grab a little green. I'll wipe off the extra paint. I'm not gonna grab any water, just wipe it. And you kind of get the feeling of when you need to actually wash it and when you can just get by with wiping it and carrying on your merry way. I can't teach that. I think it's just something you... Probably a proper teacher would say, always wash it, Lindsay. Oh my gosh. What the heck, lady? I don't know. Is that what a proper teacher sounds like? I like the dirty brush method because then you get that harmony going on. As long as you're not making mud. All right, now, for these guys back here, we don't want them to really stand out that much. We want them to be kind of in the background because they're in the background. I'm gonna go ahead and just grab some, actually, you know what I think I'm gonna do? Let's get a bigger brush and let's double load it. Ooh, let's try this. Now this is, I usually wouldn't go in with a hog bristle brush this late in the game, but I think I'm gonna load it up. Well, we'll see if this works. That'll be something. Load it up with yellow, okay? I'm gonna get a little bit of white on there. All right, and let's just try stroking on some petals there. We're not gonna be fussy. We're just gonna get... I feel like this brush might be a little too... might be too rough for this, but... No, maybe not. I think that might be all right. Remember, these are the background. Getting a little more yellow, a little smidgen of red. Because remember, it's an illusion. It's all an illusion. Okay, these are more background, out of focus flowers, so we want them to remain out of focus. Maybe a little bit of green, dirty brush green, right there in the bottom. Yeah, I gotta get in there with a little bit of a smaller brush, drag that up a little bit. Our stems aren't quite done either, so don't worry about those. I think I will do a speed paint of this as well, just because I feel like it's taking quite a bit of time, and I'm using way more yellow than I thought. I'm glad I bought 2 bottles of that. Let's do a little more yellow on that side. I felt like I kind of lost that edge. Not that I want it to be really sharp, but I don't want to lose the edge either. All right, now let me wipe that. Yeah, we're still going with the dirty brush. We're just wiping it. I'm not cleaning it properly. And we're getting a little bit of white on there. I'm going to stroke in a few petals over here. I love brush strokes. I love seeing the visceral, choppy brush strokes. I think it looks nice when you contrast against something that's a little more defined. Okay, we're getting a little bit of red. So my brush, I should show you this, my goodness gracious. So I've got the yellow and I'm just tapping it into a little bit of red. And I am actually gonna stroke upwards on these. There, don't mess with it. I know it's hard. It's so hard not to mess with it. That's probably the good thing if you tend to be someone who messes with it to try this, because unlike oils, it's gonna dry and then you can't mess with it. You gotta go over and paint the whole thing if you want to go back in. Oh, that's a little too watery, but I think we'll be fine. Yeah, that'll be all right. All right, so we get this guy down here and we're gonna do the same thing once more. Dirty brush. We're gonna repaint that stem, so just don't even worry about it. And yeah, we'll do a little bit of green. Yeah, I guess I don't have anything to say right now. Oh, I should play some lovely music. I'm gonna put music on the speed paint. I think I probably will voice it over too. I'm like, geez, do I do just the voice? Do I do just the music? Do I do both? I like those jazzy sounds. I found some jazzy music to put on my speed paints, and I like it. So it's a mixed reviews on the jazzy music. I think it's very awesome. Actually, it is lovely music. Kevin MacLeod is one of these fabulous guys who has all this wonderful royalty-free music for YouTubers. So if you're a YouTuber and you're contemplating using maybe, I don't know, the latest Katy Perry song, don't do it. You're going to get yourself into a world of trouble. But this guy, Kevin MacLeod, puts all kinds of free tracks for people to use, royalty-free, you're free to use them. He's just so generous. I think, you know, probably just the ads on his site pay his time, but I mean, my gosh, he's put out hundreds of songs. It's just such a fantastic resource. I'm so fortunate to have found his stuff. All right, so I added a little bit of highlight on that stem. I'm gonna go around and do the same thing on these guys too. Just try to get it along the edge. Now, if you've ever done toll painting in the past, those brushes are for acrylic, so you go right ahead and use those on your canvas work as well. You may want some hog bristles too, just because they push the paint around a little bit better. I'll show you this technique. I'm gonna load with a little bit of green, twisting as I go. This is a pretty big brush. This is a number 6 long handled, which is a little bit bigger. It does seem to be a little bit bigger than a short handled, like a watercolor number 6. Doesn't point as well. And then I put yellow, green, yellow, and then a touch of white. And I'm gonna do this stem here with that. Got a little too much up there. I'm gonna spread it around here. And feather it up. Maybe add a little bit, touch more green in there. And I feel like there's Facebook saying hello. Hello, Facebook. I wonder who was trying to reach me. Maybe one of you guys? I don't know. Okay, I like that. I want that on that 404 one there, so I'm gonna do it again. Green, touch of yellow, touch of white, triple loading. On a round brush. Alright, except I'm not going to start so high up so I can feather it up. I'm going to just start a ways down, then I'm going to work it up so that I don't end up with weirdness. Wiping my brush a little bit, now I'm going to just blend it back in. Something to make it come out against the background a little bit. I feel like I need a little more green. I think I overdid it. I put too much white on there, I think. So don't put so much white on there when you do it to yours. Okay, now at this stage, boy, that does look a little stark. All right. Now at this stage, I usually add any highlights and things. I feel like I want some dark green leaves though. I feel like I really need like another layer of depth. So I'm gonna go right in. I think what I'm gonna do is actually take my sap green, which I just my favorite color, I love it. I add a little bit of the blue that we used for the sky, the ultramarine blue. That's gonna give me a really rich, dark. See that? It's almost like a midnight green. Okay. I'm actually going to go for a different brush. I want a flat that's fairly sharp. Let's see. This one might be stiff enough. I'm not sure. It's a synthetic, but it might be stiff enough. If not, I'll have to find a hog. And this is a Nicole brush. It's not even a very expensive brush. I'm just loading both sides. Look, drag, 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 drag. That's getting both sides loaded in paint at the tip. And I'm gonna add a few little blades of grass. Go right off the edge. If it's dragging too much, you can add a smidgen of water, just a little smidgen, okay? No, I don't know exactly how much a smidgen is, it's like a drop. Okay, I don't know. All right, and I think I'll maybe do one, maybe I'll even start one up high here and go down, press, twist a little bit when you wanted to go thin, when you wanted to go thick, I mean, twist back and come down when you wanted to go thick. You know, so you can make these multi-dimensional leaves. Okay, I want it nice and fat at the bottom, so I'm going the full chisel edge there, the full flat edge, dragging it over to the edge. Now something that's kind of cool that you can do is you can load the side, and I think with this dark green leaf, I think I just want some maybe white on the side. Okay, so I got a little white on the side. I'm going to tap it off a little bit, because that's quite a bit. side loading, or this is actually double loading, and I'm going to move my canvas because, and that's really going to look funky at the speed paint, I am just giving a little bit of highlight rather there, a little bit of highlight here. Okay, don't be afraid to turn your painting when you want to. Now another thing you could do is go on the chisel edge, try it different ways and see how you get the effect that you prefer. And maybe one more blade of grass this time. I think I want it to go maybe across a few. I think I'll start it up here and I'm just gonna go behind. Then I'll fill it in. I just wanted to make sure I didn't go over my stems, because they're probably not dry enough for me to wipe it off. If you do, like as you're working, if you go over an area that's already dried and you want to erase it, you can usually use a wet Q-tip, just like a cotton swab with a little water on it to clean it up. This could be done with a round brush as well. In fact, I'm not having that much control with that, so I might switch. I feel like it's just too stiff. I don't like that, how straight that is. Yep, let's go to a round brush and see what we can do with that. An actual clean round brush. And you know, worst comes to worst, I repaint those stems in the front, not a big deal. We have all the paint right out, ready to go, so not too biggie. Yeah, I don't like that one. That one is really like pointy. I think I'm gonna try to erase that. Let's see if we can erase that. Shall we? I think we shall. Let's see. Hopefully our background is... Oh yeah. See, I don't like that. That's going away. Don't you wish all the mistakes in life were that easy to get rid of? Bye-bye, blade of grass. Nice knowing ya. Sorry about your luck there. You had a good run. No, you had a pretty short run. That's Chinatown, folks. Blop, blop, blot. There we go. Yeah, that's fine. See? Huzzah! We're magicians. Might need to put a flower there. That's looking a little... That's looking a little bare. I wonder if we got rid of some... I think it's just because it's wet. Did we get rid of any sky there? I don't think so. I don't think we lifted up any sky. We'll know when it dries. I think it's fine, though. All right. So, let's dry this and see what we've got in a second. Okie dokie, folks. I'm going to go back in and paint those two stems. And then I think I'm going to do a dark green leaf in front, because I was not... we had a little mishap there, so we're just gonna repaint these guys and move right along. That happens, and that's a great thing about acrylics. It's fixable. So I hope I illustrated my point very well, that how fixable acrylic paints are. That's gonna be funny to watch at the speed paint, I think. Like, why is she doing that? That's strange. That's not how I would have painted it. That's my voice for a proper painting teacher. Well, that's not what I would have done. They all sound like Thurston Howell from Gilligan's Island, apparently. That's not how I would paint a tulip and acrylics. There we go. All right. Boy, that's a little weird, but I think it'll be a little darker when it dries. Okay, let's go back and try to get that decent stem in there. Get just enough blue paint there. Let's just freehand it with a round brush. There. That's pretty good. That was way easier. Yeah, that's the thing with acrylics. It's better to work back to front because you just keep adding layers on top, and it's just kind of easy that way. And then I'm just going to add a little highlight with the white into that wet paint. That's a little much. Well, now we're going to go back in with some green because it's acrylic. And we can... There we go. Maybe this guy ought to have a little bit of a white highlight then, if the other one does. There we go. Okay, now for the finishing touches, we are going to go in and add some white highlights on everything. And this is kind of like the icing on the cake. It's the sprinkles. You don't want to do too much because you could end up overworking it. In fact, I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to switch to this brush. It's a small number 4 Filbert. It's a Simmons. Simply Simmons? What is it? Robert Simmons Sienna. That's funny because I think there's a Sienna from another company too. So we're just going to go in and we're going to just kind of add it just to the tips of some of these petals. It's just going to bring out the detail, bring out the little interest in our focal ones. I'm not going to put it on the other ones. I just really want to sharpen it. It's basically what it does is it sharpens it. It sharpens your painting. I got a fur, piece of fur on this. I have fur on everything right now. Two cats and a dog. It seems like three cats. Seems like I was just telling my friend the other day, my house looks like 12 muddy puppies had a party. It's just been so, we go from like 50 degrees and everything thaws and everything's muddy to snow. It's insane. All right, I'm gonna turn this so I can get, actually maybe I don't have to. I'm trying to be mindful of the fact that I'm gonna speed this up as well as do the real time tutorial. So make sure you check for that if you're curious. It also would be a good thing, like if you have a friend that wants to learn how to paint, you could say, well, go check out the quick one. If you like it, then do the fast one, because I know it can be daunting to think about sitting and watching, you know, 45 minutes of somebody painting. All right, I'm pretty happy with that. I'm going to sign my name. I think I'll sign it down here in yellow. Hopefully I have a fine enough brush here. And then I will be applying a coat of water-based varnish after it's completely dry. In fact, I'll just sign off now because you don't need to see me write my name. You'll see the photo and the thumbnail, how it all turned out. Please give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you like these long videos. Share it with your friends in your painting groups and Pinterest and wherever you like to share things. I do appreciate it and it really helps my channel out. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, happy crafting.